Well, last hour we introduced you to the Hadashell family. They had no idea that they were spending their last Christmas with their son Kevin 2 years ago.
He just said, "Kevin died." I just screamed and couldn't believe it.
When they said he died of ketoacidosis, and I said, "What?" He said, "I have no explanation for that other than he was non-compliant, that he wasn't taking his medication."
His mother contends Kevin, who is a diabetic, was faithful about taking his insulin. And it turns out Kevin tried to get more when he ran out, but he was denied the medication. In the meantime, he thought he was just getting the flu. What was really happening? His organs were shutting down. He was dying, essentially, and he didn't even know it. And he died alone in his apartment. That's when the Hadashells knew that they couldn't let any family go through what they were going through.
Kevin did not want to die. Kevin took care of himself.
Kevin Hadashell, a son, a brother, a diabetic, died because he ran out of insulin and in the midst of the holiday season couldn't get through to his doctor to fill his prescription one more time.
And it's not just insulin. It affects other people with other diseases also. So we did some investigating and found Ohio law as it was at the time was in an emergency situation, pharmacists could give a 72-hour emergency prescription, up to 72 hours. Problem being is that insulin is not packaged in that small quantity.
How can this be? How can someone be on a life-sustaining drug and be turned away?
And with that question, their mission, dubbed Howdy's Law, was born. It's a proposal to secure that anyone suffering from diabetes would be able to get an emergency supply of insulin from a pharmacy if their doctor couldn't be reached. They worked feverishly, got connected to Senator Dave Burke, a pharmacist who, ironically, already had this problem on his mind.
This had to go broader.
Their local TV station in Cleveland aired Kevin's story, and seemingly overnight, the bureaucratic wheels started turning faster.
The next day, we were getting phone calls from Columbus, mostly pharmacy lobbyists that wanted to know more, and the law got fast-tracked, we think, from that point. It only took 14 months to get it passed.
When they gave their personal testimony to the legislature in Columbus, they knew Kevin's story was going to save lives.
The whole legislation was leaning forward, listening on every word.
They credit Senator Burke and then newly elected Representative Nathan Manning with putting their urgency into physical motion.
On this bill, he called every other representative personally to garner support to get this passed.
He was a tiger, and he pushed.
Judy says it was a sign from heaven. The day Governor John Kasich, who was on the campaign trail, took a moment to sign the bill into law.
That was December 22nd. Kevin was born on 2/22. Kevin was the sacrificial lamb. And yet, there's still so much more that needs to be done.
Their new mission? To make sure a diabetes test is included in every child's well visit to the doctor. It's a simple blood test, just a prick on the finger, that could keep your child healthy and alive.
Diabetes is an epidemic. The numbers support it, and it's not being treated as an epidemic.
No.
And it needs to be.
This is what they hope will be Kevin's legacy, and they hope somehow he's proud of what they're doing.
What do you think he would say to you now?
Keep making memories, keep living my life, and that he's always with me, and he'll be my guardian angel until it's time to meet again.
Howdy's Law is prompting other states to look at the issue and take action there. Florida passed their version of Howdy's Law last spring. Pennsylvania just submitted Senate Bill 1409, and at least a half dozen other states are looking to enact similar legislation. For more information, you can go to the family's Facebook page, In Memory of Kevin Howdy Hadashell.